Morning, Steve Fried in Chicago with the Morning Grain Comments. Markets are mixed lower. We've got beans down, soybean oil down, corn and wheat about unchanged. Outside markets kind of on hold, waiting for Fed comments today in Jackson Hole at 9 o'clock Central Time. Crude oil is a little bit higher on concern about some of the Middle East tensions that are going on right now and what could happen down the road. And as far as the grains this week are concerned, we saw that for the month, soybeans futures are down 33 cents, soybean oil is down 4 cents a pound, corn's up a penny, Chicago wheat's up 26 cents, KC 44 cents, and Minneapolis 20 cents. And I think in the beans, what we're seeing is just concern about demand. Also some relatively big numbers coming out of South America for their 2022 crop. We also in the corn kind of bouncing around between support and resistance in a trading range with the upcoming harvest and slow start to our new export sales year offering resistance, whereas the lack of farmers selling, strong basis levels, and good domestic demand offering support to the corn. Right now, in the Southwest Plains, corn prices are $35 a ton cheaper than hard red winter wheat. In the wheat market, I think we're just trading supply concerns as the non-US wheat exporter stocks to usage ratio are record low. And we would expect in September the USDA to continue to drop the Russian crop, and on Monday we could see a lower Canada crop. And so all those things remains tight as far as wheat is concerned. We do note that down in South America, southern Brazil, northern Argentina could get some rains, which is helping soils there for planting. We also note that here in the US, overnight, we saw some real good rains across southern Minnesota and northern Iowa. And these areas could get more rains next week. South of that rain line, though, you're seeing record high heat index numbers that could be stressing the crops there. We did see this week a private crop survey estimate in central Illinois that the corn crop could be record high yields in that area. The pod count is also above average and above last year, but the rains are needed to fill those pods. And I think in general, a lot of people feel that this $13 November price should be supportive, and $5.40 in the corn should be supportive, and $7 Kansas City D Sweet should also be a supportive price. But we need demand to keep the market above those price levels. We also note that we'll be watching what is going on as far as the COVID virus and the impact it might have on our GDP and our food and fuel demand. Hope everybody has a safe weekend. As always, these are my thoughts, not those of ADM, Radio Investor Services. Have a safe and profitable trading day. Remember, always treat people like you yourself would like to be treated.